It's hard for us living in the wealthy West to imagine a level of poverty in which a mother and her young daughter are forced into prostitution just to survive. But the cruel irony is that in Madagascar, this situation is being driven by thousands of well-off Europeans who fly in on sex tours. Nick Lazaridis took a hidden camera into the bars and brothels of the capital to report on the booming trade in child prostitution and the young locals trying to prevent it.
In Madagascar's capital, my guide is taking me on a clandestine tour of some of the city's booming brothels.
Hey, this menu is for two girls.
Okay.
This menu is for one girl.
Okay.
As you enter, you're given a menu, but what's on offer isn't likely to feature in any good food guide.
The arra de la rose. It's if it isn't, man, that's...
Prostitution is legal in Madagascar, but not for those under the age of 18. But here, no one seems to care.
Une fois que vous arrivez tout seul, vous êtes un étranger. Le chauffeur de taxi qui vous ramène en ville va vous contacter en disant « Vous voulez une jeune fille mineure ? Est-ce qu'une jeune fille vierge ? Est-ce qu'un garçon ? Est-ce qu'une jeune fille de quel âge vous voulez avoir ?»
In the 90s, Madagascar's beaches and laid-back lifestyle enticed planeloads of holidaying European families. Now many of the visitors are sex tourists. Foreign men and women on the prowl.
C'est déjà au niveau de l'hôtel, organisé aussi avec des photos même si vous voulez. Une fois que vous arrivez à la plage là, c'est les propriétaires de maisons de location, maisons de passe qui va vous contacter ou bien c'est les parents eux-mêmes qui vont vous contacter. J'ai une fille, elle est belle, elle, etc.
Ngara kuzini warda da Jose 14 angala 15 ans de mizaza tsimianatra defa resistoe mano plaisir en balade la plage karainze bamtatade e sansanjenteng azizo wanga vola.
It's confronting to discover that many of Madagascar's child sex workers are encouraged by their parents. Sua and Warda are mother and daughter. Both are sex workers. When the neighbours gossip, Sua bites her tongue. She knows what her daughter does is shameful, but it puts food on the table. Daily flights from Europe bring sex tourists to Antananarivo, Madagascar's chaotic capital. And the locals know what they're after. For tourists with a taste for schoolgirls, Albert can help. He's not yet 18, but he's a pimp, arranging lunch hour meetings with girls fresh out of the classroom.
Miscontacto.
mis contacto un vidi sim. Mura ka mura chununa kra voresa pula te lina pez e mura chununa resputs ni zia fiu.
Zade ci sul tagimza. Zamdena ndete te ze fanod kamarad. Zamdena nganu ze asta na tonto. Ah, nem ir facor é tão tenha fatis direndo fatis cara cara. Antenga fatis que met fekin na to.
Natalie is just 11, but is already a veteran of Madagascar's sleazy sex trade. She lost her virginity to an elderly sex tourist for the equivalent of $21.
Na nem ir facor com a tão tenha fatis imperimi. Ninguém fica.
It's here on the idyllic beaches of Nosy Bay, an island off Madagascar's north coast, that the child sex trade is rampant.
Ponaka importe lo importalira. Rahulu diabi. Amtika no sibehetu. Natapa karatwetin vazahati.
Madame Florine is president of the Nosy Bay Sex Workers Collective. She's made herself unpopular by speaking out against child sex tourists.
Zama henin satevandozu. Valuan satevandozufa, everndrofa is gofamis vazaman de camera havetu, karatotska joyu. Everndrofa and de kretigrahamba to luakaetu. With Chevian tourist Bakandafi and they here to fa, our team and Rubka business.
It's no surprise that in the grubby entertainment quarter of Ambataloka Beach, bar owners and their customers don't want to be filmed. So I shot this video with a hidden camera. It was clear that at least half of the girls inside the bars were well under the age of consent. Officially in Madagascar, there is zero tolerance for sex tourists preying on children. Posters warn of harsh prison sentences for anyone caught engaging in sexual acts with minors. Hotels are obliged to report suspicious guests to the police, but the rules are easy to circumvent. It's not just young girls who are caught up in Madagascar's sex tourism industry, nor are the foreign predators all men. This is a trade that exploits both females and males. Just 16, Eric has already worked as a prostitute for 2 years. His clients, both men and women, have a taste for young boys. Eric earns in a month as much as the average Madagascan family can earn in a year. Eric says the underage male prostitutes follow much the same routine as the females. They work the beaches, but on weekends they concentrate on the bars.
Mangan
Madagascar's female sex tourists have their own networks in place. They arrive with phone numbers to call. In theory, Madagascar's authorities are trying to combat the child sex trade. I joined the local police as they made a patrol of the club area. It's early in the evening and there are very few people in the bars. While their intentions are good, Madagascar's police force is starved of funds. Here on Nosy Bay, where they can't even afford to fill up their patrol cars with petrol, checks like this are performed only once a month.
Dans les coulisses, il faut qu'ils tiennent les places publiques. De n'importe où, il y a un problème en fantanga. Il faut qu'on décide de demander une mitmandisque sortir.
With some parents pimping their own kids, prosecuting foreigners for sex crimes is difficult.
Yeah, une fermière, moi, une brune, il doit s'asseoir sur un zéma la marara roufa. Ni, you know.
Il a la police, il a le ministère du tourisme, il a le ministère qui protège tout ce qui est protection de l'enfant, le ministère de la population au niveau régional, etc. Tout le monde ferme les yeux.
Gianoda Randimbiason, a social worker for UNICEF, says the Madagascan authorities lack the will to do what's necessary.
Il y a les réseaux de protection avec le service public et le service privé, et on dirait que c'est comme un réseau. Parce qu'à force de ne pas dire, à force de ne pas dénoncer, ça veut dire qu'on est impliqué comme on est en train de protéger l'auteur, on est en train de ne pas tenir compte de l'intérêt supérieur de l'enfant, c'est que ça veut dire qu'on est dans les réseaux.
Ironically, failed by adults, it's Madagascar's young kids themselves who are taking action. Eduardo and Ernest lead a group called the Child Protection Brigade, and they uncover what the authorities fail to see. Many sex tourists rent private houses in order to stay under the radar. But they don't escape the attention of the Child Protection Brigade.
Example, I'm Tang Zing.
Yeah.
You was on Petrikam New. By Tang Zing, the Yavim Savi Savatom, Bokam Lagariat Zing.
Yeah.
Zavan Tsaran, Zavan Tien Zing. Zim Petrikam, the Tazazo, Zim Tangrayo, Lerzim Zavyav, Zemandalit Zing, Zen Stodzrut, Bokam Biara, Batulokan Zing, Kayun Zimandem Samran, Alizit Mandela.
Amazing of Falalanga Zing Pianar Zero.
In their village workshop, Eduardo and Ernest devise strategies to keep young Madagascans out of the sex industry.
Uh-huh.
By day, the workshop is the headquarters for organising patrols and making contact with child sex workers. In one of the poorest countries on earth, the relative prosperity enjoyed by child sex workers attracts others to a job that's short on glamour but well paid.
Même si on va faire les tapages ou la sensibilisation dans ce sens-là, s'il n'y a pas l'application de la loi à Madagascar, il n'y a pas de l'application de la loi, alors là tout le monde continue que c'est comme on est en train de faire le génocide de nos enfants malgaches, comme au détriment de nos enfants malgaches.
Da universidade, essa da minha ambassadeira, na droga.